Imagine a business wants to open a new coal mine, or to build a new factory, or exploit land for agriculture. These kinds of projects can have a huge impact on the environment and people living nearby. To predict the impact of such projects and to limit their consequences, a sub-decree on environment impact assessment process requires a company or a public project manager in Cambodia to conduct an EIA. EIA stands for Environment Impact Assessment, and in this video, we will briefly explain what an EIA is, in which case it has to be conducted, and what changes can be expected in the future. Generally speaking, an environmental impact assessment is a structured investigation that aims to predict the effects that a project or policy may have. EIAs are carried out before work begins on mining projects, dam construction, economic land concessions, and many other types of activity. In a precas issued by the Ministry of Environment, the contents of a full EIA are specified. Among other requirements, an EIA should include a full project description of existing environmental resources, any public comments, environmental impact mitigation or measures, and an environment management plan. But in which cases is a project owner required to issue an EIA report? Chapter 3 of the Law on Environmental Protection and Natural Resource Management requires that an environmental impact assessment be conducted for projects likely to have an impact on the environment, whether they are public or privately funded. A sub-decree specifies these cases by listing some fields where an EIA is necessary: agro-industry, wood and paper production, power plants, tourism, and infrastructure are some of them. However, the sub-decree also includes an exemption for special and crucial projects approved by the royal government. The Ministry of Environment, together with other related ministries, is responsible for the review of EIAs. The review process works like this. First, an initial EIA and a project feasibility report have to be submitted by the project owner. The ministry then decides whether the project may have serious impacts on natural resources, ecosystems, health, or public welfare. In the case of a coal mine or a factory, it is very likely that the construction of such building projects might impact the lives of many people, as well as the environment. If the ministry decides that this is the case, the company has to submit a full EIA, including the aforementioned contents. Once submitted, the ministry must respond with findings and recommendations within 30 days. However, if the ministry fails to respond in this time, the report is automatically assumed to be in compliance. In Cambodia, the current EIA legal framework, as described in this video, is incomplete, and in practice, EIAs are not always conducted properly. That's why a new EIA law is on its way. The drafts of the new law contain some important changes compared to the current law, aiming to improve EIA's effectiveness, transparency, and participatory character. However, the new EIA is still in its drafting phase and has not yet been ratified. Hence, it is not entirely clear what the new EIA law will eventually look like. In order to achieve more transparency for all parties, Open Development Cambodia has published and updated all important EIA information on its website. Additionally, on our profile page, you can find some examples of already conducted EIAs. This is a great opportunity for the public to learn more about the EIA process and the specific projects already approved through this process. ODC hopes that we provided you with the most important information on EIAs in this video. If you still have questions about EIAs or ODC's services, please send us a message on Facebook or via email. Thanks for watching this video by Open Development Cambodia.